Once the hatches are closed on both sides of the docking interface, here comes Whitson for final farewells, final hugs, as she departs the space station 288 days into this mission. Fyodor Yurchikhin patting the hatchway as if to say, attaboy. Again, the departing crew now back inside the Soyuz MS-04. They'll close the hatch on their side of the docking interface. The same will be done on the Poisk module side of the docking interface. Then leak checks will be conducted for a period of about an hour or so to make sure that we have an airtight seal between the two spacecraft before the depressurization of the small passageway between Poisk and the Soyuz spacecraft. The departing crew will don their Russian Sokol launch and entry suits and conduct systems checks and communications checks on those suits. And the Soyuz hatch closed at 1:41 p.m. Central Time. So Whitson, Fischer, and Yurchikhin now ensconced inside the Soyuz MS-04 spacecraft will stand by for the closure of the Poisk module hatch. And the Poisk module hatch closed at 1:43 p.m. So the hatches are now closed between the International Space Station and the Soyuz MSO-4 spacecraft, setting the stage for the undocking of the Soyuz to start the journey home for Peggy Whitson, Jack Fischer, and Fyodor Yurchikhin. The undocking scheduled about 3 hours and 14 minutes from now at 4:58 p.m. Central Time, 5:58 p.m. Eastern Time. There is Sergei Rozansky in the middle of your screen as he ensured the hatch closure on the Poisk module side of the docking interface to the Soyuz MSO-4. Randy Bresnik with his back to the camera, and Paolo Nespoli with the video camera on the left side of your screen, taking imagery of this first stage of the departure of the Expedition 52 crew from the International Space Station.